So last week I released a video letting you guys know that Amazon had opted to move away from Android on their Fire TV devices. This will essentially shake up the streaming market, in my opinion, because this will block your ability to install any third-party applications on Amazon devices. Now, the move is set to happen early next year, and what we're going to see is new Fire TV sticks shipping with a new Amazon operating system, and also old Fire TV devices, which includes your Fire Stick, your Fire TV devices, will update, thus moving away from Android completely and going towards a proprietary Amazon operating system. Now, the big deal about this is that this will stop your ability to install third-party applications, thus putting the Fire TV devices on par with the likes of Roku and Apple TV. Now, after I released that video, questions started coming up of what are the three alternatives to the Amazon Fire TV devices. Well, today's video, I'm going to give you my top three devices that can replace your Fire TV stick. Watch the entire video. If you're new to the channel, subscribe, smash the notification bell. Let's go. Now, over the past year, pool cleaning robots have gained significant popularity. Now, if you subscribe, you know that I did review the Apros Hego Pro over the summer, and this has saved me not only time but also saved me energy with some of the features that's included on this product. Now, of course, one of the best things is that this is extremely easy to use, guys. Simply select the dial, select your cleaning mode, put it in the water, and it does its thing. Now, Apros Hego Pro does have a lot of diverse cleaning features. Now, this includes floor cleaning, wall cleaning, as well as waterline cleaning. In addition, it has a built-in 9,000 milliamp hour battery that is capable of cleaning up to 180 minutes. Now, in my opinion, this will be a great gift for any pool owner. Now, today I'm excited to announce that I partnered with Apros once again to secure the best prize for this year's Black Friday. Now, during Black Friday, the official website, apros.com, it's provided a limited time 50% discount with prices as low as $409. Now, the 50% sales will be happening on Thanksgiving and Black Friday, and the times that these will be posting is 9 o'clock, 1500, 2200, as well as midnight. I'll post this information in the description. Go ahead and check it out. Make sure your alarm is set. And again, if you miss out on any one of these 50% off discounts, you can still use my coupon code EXTRA50 to get additional savings throughout the rest of the year. Now, before we jump into it, three disclaimers. The first one is that for this video, I have excluded the cheap Chinese TV boxes. Yes, those work, but over my years of doing this, guys, I've bought hundreds of devices. Some of those cheap Chinese boxes are not consistent with their updates. Hardware support for these devices are non-existent for the most part. And also, some of them lack features like official Netflix, official apps. Just having said that, I couldn't recommend or put those on this list. Second thing we're going to address is the NVIDIA Shield TV. Now, the NVIDIA Shield TV can replace the Amazon Fire TV stick, but in my opinion, this is in a different category altogether. Pricing is going to be a lot more on NVIDIA Shield TV, but if you have the cash flow and you want to just get a device that you know is going to withstand the test of time, NVIDIA Shield is a good option. Third thing that I wanted to mention is that I've also excluded Apple TVs and Rokus as alternatives for the Fire TV stick, and the main reason is because these are locked down. These are not going to allow you to install third-party applications, so essentially what you're going from the Fire TV stick or the new updates on the Fire TV stick is exactly what you're going to run into with Roku or Apple TV. Not to take anything away from those, but those are great devices, but they lack that feature that we're looking for. So having said all that, let's work our way from the third recommendation all the way to one, which one being the best. Now, device number three is going to be the Chromecast with Google TV. Now, Chromecast has been around for a while. They do have two versions. They do have a 1080p and a 4K version, with the 4K being a little bit older, but especially here on Black Friday or Black Friday sale, these are really marked down to put them right on par with the Amazon Fire TV sticks. Now, the HD version is newer. This one is running $19, and the 4K version, which is a little bit older, is $37. Now, just to go over some of the main features, this is an official Google device, does give you 4K HDR. This does have Google TV, which is a polished up version of Android. So this is always receiving regular updates. So this will have all the streaming apps that you need. And in addition, this is going to allow you to install your third-party applications. As far as the specifications, we're going to have 2 gigs of RAM, 4 gigs of internal storage. We're going to have a 4-core ARM Cortex A55, and this maxes out at 1908 megahertz. So the only reason why this isn't higher is because I feel like this is outdated. It is a couple years old, and I'm waiting for Google to release a newer 4K Google TV. Device number 2 is going to be the Xiaomi Mi Box S. Now, this is a 4K HDR Android TV device. So essentially, this is going to have the same user interface as NVIDIA Shield TV, and it does have the Google Assistant built in. Price on this is currently $64. And the reason why I included this is because I've had a couple Mi Boxes over the past couple of years, including this one. And over the past couple of years, this has been a rock star. No issues, received regular updates. These are solid streaming devices, certified Google devices, and of course, they allow you the ability to install your third-party applications. The remote is really well put together, easy to use. Mi Box has a really sleek design, and this does have a USB port, which the Fire TV lacks. Video support for this is going to be 4K at 60 frames per second. This does support Dolby Audio, DTS, supports Dolby Vision, also HDR10, and does have multiple languages. Now, this is going to have 2 gigs of RAM, 8 gigs of internal storage, ARM Mali G31 graphics card, quad-core Cortex A55 processor. So, solid streaming device. Couldn't go wrong picking this one up. And my number one recommendation to replace the Amazon Fire TV stick is the Walmart on 4K streaming box with Google TV. Now, Google TV interface is going to be identical to what we see on the Chromecast with Google TV. This, in my opinion, is the best competitor with the Fire TV stick. And one of the reasons for that is priced currently at $19. As far as the specifications, this does have 4K UHD resolution, 2 gigs of RAM, 8 gigs of storage. CPU is going to be a quad-core Cortex A35. GPU is going to be Mali G31 MP2. And this also is going to support Dolby Audio. Now, I did review this box as well, and I'll go ahead and link that video below. That way, you can go ahead and check out the full review. This is a brand new 2023 model. Really impressed with this box and its price right there with the Fire TV stick. So let me know your thoughts on the 3 alternatives to the Fire TV stick. What would you insert in there? What would you take out? Do you agree with my assessment to exclude the Chinese boxes, the NVIDIA Shield TV, as well as Apple and Roku from this list? Also, check the description where I'll link all these products where you can go ahead and check them out. If you're new to this channel, subscribe, smash the notification bell. Thank you for watching, and I'll catch you on the next one.